Well, it's par for the course in Hollywood. We don't ever get anything different. Every movie is cookie cutter the same. Every casting choice is cookie cutter the same. Everything is a homogenous block called diversity and inclusivity, ironically enough. Now, I've really not been a fan of Batgirl in a long time. I started in comics, actually, as a writer, because I was kind of upset with the way that they canceled the Stephanie Brown Batgirl comic book prior to the launch of New 52. And because of that, I actually started writing my own comic book. So if you're new to the channel, I've got a ton of different books on Amazon that you can check out from all different genres. But my superhero one, if you're a fan of Batgirl or Supergirl or anything along those lines, is Flying Sparks. You will love Flying Sparks. It's the story of a hero, Metagirl here, who is dating a villain under her secret identity and doesn't know it, so hijinks ensue. It's 12 issues long. We're about to wrap up the 13th right now, and we are chugging along to get that fifth volume to kind of wrap up the storyline out and done. It doesn't feature a redhead in it, or a ginger, but we will have that in the next upcoming graphic novel coming soon. For now, read Flying Sparks, catch up on my work, catch up on everything cool that's going on. We are all about real heroism, real comic books, and real fun here at the channel, and I appreciate everybody who supports. That link is in the description below for you to pick up the book today. But the talk of the day is Batgirl has been cast. And, of course, Batgirl being Barbara Gordon, being a redhead, you knew exactly what was going to happen when this all occurred. I could have called this, and I did call this a long time ago before casting was even announced, that they were going to race swap and replace, because that's what they do every commercial, every TV show, every movie these days, especially when it comes to redheads for some reason. Hollywood is just anti-redhead in every regard. It's very, very bizarre. And they usually cast a black woman in the role. That is typically how they do things. That is typically like what they like to push. But I guess the big twist is that they're going with a Latina at this point instead of a black woman. So they're changing up their demographic shifts based on their board algorithms that they say will probably the most views or the most sales or whatever it is they go for these days, because it's on HBO Max. I don't really know how their business model works anymore. I guess these movies are trying to drive subscriptions or whatever, and we'll see how that turns out. I know that Disney, with the Black Widow movie, is having some shaky returns for what they wanted from that movie based on their whole Disney Plus subscription model. But I can rant about that for another hour, putting a movie up for $29.99, but you already have to pay $4.99 a month even to get access to it. Oh my gosh, it's absurd. HBO Max is at least doing a little bit better of a business model where if you subscribe, you get the movie. We'll see how that goes long term, because I don't know if these movies with these high budgets can sustain that sort of thing. But there they are. This is the gal. Her name is Leslie Grace, apparently. And she is the Barbara Gordon Batgirl, even though she really does not have the look of a Barbara Gordon Batgirl. We'll see how it goes. I'm expecting this to be very similar to everything else that is going on. And as you see, DC Universe has cast three Latina actresses in key film roles this year. How exciting. How diverse. How different. How amazing and stunning and brave. We have Grace, who's joining Sasha Calle, Supergirl in The Flash. Yay. And Rachel Zegler, who's got a mystery role in Shazam. So every white person is now being replaced by some sort of minority who is in a superhero leading role. That is what we got for the day. And there's honestly nothing to say about it at this point. It's just going to keep happening. This is the globalist agenda that is happening through Hollywood. They want to replace everything you hold dear. And at some point, they're expecting you not to remember the original and how great it was anymore, and just accept their version of reality. That's the whole point. What do you think about this? Leave a comment down below. Let me know. And hit the like and subscribe button. We'll be back soon with more comic news content.